All week long, we've been talking about different Blue Zones projects in Hawaii. Yesterday, we learned about community gardening. Today, we're taking food from the garden to the kitchen at Windward Community College.
Yeah, that's actually where nursing students are learning how to cook using Native Hawaiian traditions. Check it out.
Okay, I'm pretty excited about this. I'm at the Windward Community College campus, and I'm joined by Jamie Boyd, who's coming in to tell us about a unique program that you've been a part of. What's in the program that you've been a part of?
I'm the coordinator for the nursing pathway program at Windward Community College. Mm-hmm. We started in 2007 in response to the Department of Labor, the state's call to increase the number of workers prepared to care for the aging population. So we did that, and it's outside of Hawaiian ways of knowing and being to train them for these low-wage jobs and leave them there. So we built the pathway so that they could climb up, and we did so in a Native Hawaiian relevant way where it's highly attached to aina and healthy foods, and that's in line with what the World Health Organization is saying about chronic disease prevention, that there has to be more fitness and more healthy whole foods, which is also in line with the Blue Zone project.
Have you seen the difference when you see patients that are part of this living from the food from the aina, that it makes a difference in their overall health? Have you seen that?
Absolutely. We have been working with Luna Lila Home for 3 years, and the residents there especially love that we are bringing whole fresh foods from our garden to them and preparing it there. They love that young nurses are coming. And so to pair the young nurses with the aged has been also culturally appropriate for us.
Mm-hmm. And it's so nice that the nurses, though, are learning these skills, and then they can take it and share them and really change the way the culture that we look at nurses acting. I mean, it's just nice to see them learning how to take these cooking skills and nutrition values.
Right. In a Native Hawaiian way of knowing, right, it's the student who has to know first.
Oh.
So they're taking this home to their family first and for themselves, that they come back to college with healthier lunches.
Wow.
Right, not just training them to be nurses who live unhealthy and then try to encourage other people to live healthier than they do themselves.
Carry the lessons on into their life.
Now, right.
Carrying, speaking of which, how did you guys hook up with the Blue Zones Project? And talk about that unique partnership that you guys have.
In addition to coordinating the nursing pathway on campus, I also teach nutrition. And so I have been including the Blue Zones Project in my nutrition class for years.
Interesting.
And then about 6 months ago or so, this region had an opportunity to compete for a chance to work with Blue Zones Project amongst other localities across the nation, and so we competed and we won.
Nice.
So now we're in full gear.
Yeah, and really the response has been amazing. If there's somebody out there though that also wants to maybe follow in your footsteps and is really inspired, what would be your advice to them in contacting or getting part of this whole project?
They could find Google the Blue Zones Project. I'm just the co-chair for one committee. They can reach me at Windward Community College. Yeah. I'll be happy to direct them to some committee that suits their passion. But the Blue Zones Project is now firmly situated in Koolaupok, so easy to find.
I know, and it's exciting. And actually, we have a kickoff event coming up very, very soon. But part of that, and I know Chef is busy right on here. Chef, come on down. Thank you for having us. Now, talk about the students right here and what they're carrying, what kind of skills they're learning, and more importantly, what are the ingredients that they're working with here today?
Well, we've got sauteed tofu that we are going to make a chickpea flour gravy, and that's kind of a nice way to show to add a little extra vegetarian protein and a wonderful way to make a nice healthy gravy. We are sauteing with onions and fresh herbs and garlic for that. We're making a cauliflower rice.
Ooh.
And so the cauliflower rice is Moroccan spice. We have all kinds of spices we're putting together. We're sauteing it with some red bell pepper and red onion and tomato and currants and almonds.
I'm getting hungry as it is, but I gotta ask for a teacher, when you're teaching and trying to learn these skills, and is it easy or challenge when they're trying to learn to cook with healthy, natural foods that you guys actually just grew right outside? Is it harder or more difficult or more fun? What would you say the cooking style is?
I think it's great fun, and the students are always really open, and it's exciting for them to see the different options out there. And I like to be able to share these different ways of cooking so that they can take it on and work with their patients mm-hmm. on what they learn. So.
And not only that, but take it back to their own homes mm-hmm. and families
exactly,
as well.
Exactly. Start at home first. So we're trying to always encourage them to try it with their families mm-hmm. and then also to take it with them, knowledge base.
Awesome. Well, hopefully I'll get a taste a little bit later when they're done cooking. But again, we're going to have all the information on the kickoff event, but you got to come and check it out. Great things that are done by great students and people with vegetables and food grown right here in Hawaii.
Yeah, and speaking of right here in Hawaii, this all couldn't be done without the help of, well, Kamehameha Schools and Queens Medical. They've actually partnered up with this nursing program, the Pathways program, to really push the Native Hawaiian culture and traditions. I mean, it's so cool. We're talking about this. Nurses learning Native Hawaiian practitioners.
At first, I thought they were culinary
right?
students.
No, and they found, though, that when they go into, you know, retirement homes or facilities, using these cooking skills makes wonders. I mean, for not only the healthy eating, but just feeling good about what they're doing. So mm-hmm. it's kind of cool.
Absolutely.
Great program.
And for more information on the Blue Zones project, because I know a lot of people may be confused about that, they have three big events happening
Huge.
This weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Go to our website, get more information, but it's really a wonderful, I had to look it up myself,
yeah.
It's this big initiative to help communities live longer, live happier, live healthier. So they're really doing a lot of wonderful things.
And it's not only here in Oahu, neighbor islands as well. So yeah, get to the website.
Actually, it's a national initiative.
Mm-hmm.
So they've already gone into many communities across the state, outside of Hawaii.
That's so cool.
And then Hawaii is just the latest initiative.
You know what I like about it too, though? It's about bringing communities together. That's what we need, more so in Hawaii. People bring together, bigger families, bigger people.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Yep, because they're teaching us how to do it.
So true.
Yeah.
So true.
Coming up on Living.